embark on our journey of rock and roll, we just got a couple of things we gotta go over first, alright? So I'm gonna ask you guys to all take a moment to turn off your cell phones, alright? Gotta maintain the vibe. We also ask you to refrain from taking any photography. I know I look really good, but there's some professional photos up on the website, and you don't want to ruin the experience for those around you, alright? Also, in case someone on stage is tearing up a guitar solo so hot they set a fire, don't worry about it because we got exits at the rear theater and up by the booth and backstage, okay? And we got some wonderful effects ready for you tonight. We got intense fog, we got strobe lights, we got all, it looks great, so just be prepared, brace yourselves, okay? Alright, one more thing. We have an incredible cast, and included in this cast are some incredible musicians, all right? And though we have a beautiful pit who's gonna be tearing it up all night for you, every kid that you see with an instrument on stage is making that music live for you with their own hands, all right? So let's give it up for them some too. All right, last, but certainly not least, I gotta ask to the stage our beloved roadies, our beloved techies, all right? They may not be rocking up here with us tonight, but they made everything on this stage possible, and we cannot be more thankful for their hard work and determination. Dedication. Woo! And then they come up and they take a bow and we clap for them, and it's pretty freaking awesome. All right, so who's ready to rock? Yeah! All right, let's get it kicked off with our first act of the night, a beautiful band by the name of No!
Such a long time. It's been a great 3 days. now?
Yes. He's trashed the house again, and I'm sick of it.
He's lived here a long time.
He's lived here longer than me, so what does that mean? I matter less?
No, no, of course not, Patty Cake. It's just... we went to high school together. We were in a band together. He's my best friend.
He's not your friend, Ned. He's a freeloader. He's rude to me, he takes advantage of you, and it's time he's paid some rent.
Waking him up in the morning is a bad idea. It's like using a beehive as a pinata. It's dangerous.
You can't live your life letting people push you around. Go do it.
Yes, I understand that guacamole is $2 extra.
Dewey.
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 Wake up, Dewey! Time to get up!
Patty, what do you want?
The rent.
You woke me for that?
Yes, I woke you for that.
I am so sick and tired of being the guy everyone comes to for the money that I owe them.
Well, sorry to disturb your beauty sleep, but we're going to work. You see, we work. I serve the mayor of the city. The whole city. And Ned? Well, Ned has the most important job there is.
Tempting?
Teaching. Substitute teaching is not a temp.
Oh, he's a babysitter. I'd like to see you try it.
Oh, sweet comeback, bro.
I don't care what you think of us, Dewey. Pay the rent.
Ned, tell her, man. The Battle of the Bands is in 3 weeks. I need every penny I make.
And so do we. And you know what? We deserve it. Why don't you sell this stupid guitar?
No, no! Would you ask Picasso to sell his guitar?
Oh my god. You're an idiot.
Ned, come on, man. You can't have forgotten what I'm playing for. What happened to you, man? You used to be a blood-sucking, cross-dressing incubus from Maggot Death.
I may look like a satanic sex god, but that's not who I am anymore.
He's moved on, Dewey. It's called growing up. Maybe you should try it.
Oh, I don't want to try it. Ned, I've been mooching off you for years, and it's never been a problem before.
Come on, Dewey. If you don't pay the rent, Patty might leave me.
Oh, so I shouldn't pay the rent.
I'm serious. I may never get another girlfriend.
Ned, when I win the Battle of the Bands, I will be rolling in the Benjamins. And that is just going to be the beginning, I promise you. I'll be strumming my axe in a basement dive by totally kick-ass men. When an army of Vietnam will arrive with pens and contracts in hand, they'll whisk me away in a big black car, and the record execs and the girls drunk young, they'll know from the sun what a major league star.
You're out. We're taking the Battle of the Bands series this year. Meet Snake.
So, don't worry about it, Dewey. Just don't pay it. We're all really good about it.
Thanks for that, Doug. Well, you know what? You're forgetting about one little thing. The music. You know what? Screw you. I don't need you. I don't need any of you.
I'll be blowing out amps, playing stadium shows on my sold-out electric tour. And I'll blister the ears of the first 1,000 rows and leave while they beg for more. And I'll pop the champagne and the party will rage. No crown M&Ms in my green room backstage. It's bigger than Hendrix and Clapton and Page. And perhaps the outer mesh. When I climb to the top of Mount Park and I'm perched at the uppermost peak, when the legion of police are tooted out, singles all over the land with my 12 grannies in hand. Watch the band boys on top at the top of Mount Rock.
You're late again, Dewey. I have to let you go.
No, Stanley, I need this job. I have to pay rent.
This was your last chance, Rockstar.
I'd put Rockstar in air quotes, but I'm carrying this grand records. The doubters and the haters and the hipsters, let them laugh.
my roadie's autograph. I know my time is coming, well hopefully it's coming. I'm pretty sure it's coming anyway, once I find a way. Then the dreams that I've had since the day I turned 10 will be finally coming true. And no one will call me a loser again or tell me what I can do. So I'll hold my head high and keep strumming those strings, and I'll grab any chance that my destiny brings. I'll rise and I'll rise and I'll rise on the wings of my soul. And Thor playing tambourine, and Elvis and Janice and Kerwin Dear, and Jesus will toss me a beer, and we'll cheer on the clock at the top of Mount Rock, at the top of Mount Rock, at the top of Mount Rock.
This is Rosalie Mullins, principal of Horace Green Prep School. Am I speaking with Mr. Ned Schneebly?
No, he's not here.
Can you take a message?
Whatever.
We have had an emergency. We need an immediate substitute to start tomorrow morning at 8:45. I'm not sure for how long, but the position will pay $950 a week.
Not $950 a week?
Yes, $950 a week.
Actually, I think he just came in the door. One second. Hello, is anybody home? Hi, Ned. The principal of Horace Green wants to talk to you. Oh, that's a fine establishment. Yeah, here you go.
Hello, this is Ned Schneebly. To whom am I speaking, please?
No running!
Hey, Jim. Zach, don't make me call you twice. Walk as if you're going somewhere. Look at you, tuck in your shirt.
Good morning, Mr. Mooneyham.
Morning.
Good morning, Zach.
Good morning, Miss Mullins.
Good morning, Mrs. Hathaway. Good morning, Summer.
Good morning, Miss Mullins.
Miss Mullins, I wondered if I could bother
you. Mom, your car's in a no parking zone.
I know, sweetie. I was just asking.
Go get the car.
Oh, okay. She's so definite.
Isn't she just?
You sure you've got everything? Your homework? Your books?
Good morning, Mr. and Mr. Spencer Williams. Hello, Tamika.
Good morning, Mrs. Mullins. How is she settling in?
It's hard to start a new school at her age, but she'll be fine.
And your cold is completely gone?
It wasn't a cold. It was just an allergy.
I'm holding her lunch. Christ, can I'm holding her lunch? Tamika!
Thank you.
Children, one word before you go. Due to Mrs. Dunham's injury, a substitute will be arriving this morning. His name is Mr. Schneebly, and I expect to see him treated with the courtesy that has made Horace Green famous. You are dismissed. Miss Mullins! Miss Mullins, when will he be here? I told him we begin at 8:45. But it's 9:45. Let's hope he arrives before 10. And will he fit in? His resume is very impressive. Can you take care of them until he arrives? Get back, all of you, now! No running! Don't cry. Do you want a hug? Deliveries are out back.
No, hi, I'm Ned Schneebly, the substitute.
You're very late, Mr. Schneebly. Never mind, you're here now. Rosalie Mullins, we spoke on the phone.
First things first, is there any chance of being paid up front?
What?
It would be really great, you know, if I could be paid now, like, in cash?
We don't do that.
Sure, but no checks made out to Ned Schneebly, all right? Everything just out to cash, you know, tax purposes.
You can take that up with Candace and administration at the end of the day. Mr. Schneebly!
When is the end of the day?
The school hours are from 8:45 to 3.
Can I cut out, like, a little early? To be honest, I had a few last night in my head. Pounding, you know. That is, if you don't mind.
I mind.
Cool, yeah, sure.
Mr. Schneebly, perhaps you're not familiar with this kind of institution. Let me explain something to you. Here at Horace Green, our name has come to mean pure excellence in every sense, which we commandeer for quite a lovely year. Checks each parent here expects their child to earn a high return, and because they do, the pressure's up for you and me. Here at Horace Green, we rule the rankings, lead in funding, test right off the chart. Greatness is routine, the board demands it, or we will both be ripped apart.
No worries with me. Gets out of line, I smack him real hard.
There is no corporal punishment at Horace Green.
But you do spank him, right?
No! At our hallowed school, the children, as a rule, learn discipline. No running! We drill it in with, as you might guess, the fear of doing less than. With the elite, till they are dispersed to Harvard or Nurse Cornell. Here at Horace Green, we take top honors, crush our rivals, wear the pencil crown. There's no in between, we get results. Here, for the ones will hunt us down. Here we are. This is your classroom. Good morning, children.
Good morning, Miss Mullins.
Thank you, Miss Scheinkopf.
You're welcome.
Children, sit. Children, this is Mrs. Dunham's substitute, Mr. Schneebly.
Good morning, Mr. Schneebly.
Why don't you write your name on the board?
Good thinking.
It's a funny S.
Oh, I'm just trying to get control of this darn chalk. Oh, stop giving me such a hard time. You know. S. Mr. S.
All right, then. Any further questions? Mr. Schneebly.
When is lunch?
Lunch is at lunchtime. And Mr. Schneebly, one last thing. Here at Horace Green, we stick to custom. Keep on schedule. Do what must be done. Don't, and it will mean I go ballistic. Right, then that's all. Good luck, have fun.
All right, who's got some food?
We're discouraged from bringing unauthorized food into the building.
No one's gonna get in any trouble. I'm hungry. You, glasses. I know you've got food.
I have a granola bar.
Give it up. Oh, what is this? Don't you have any real food?
Real food?
Yeah, a pizza, a burger. What's the matter with you?
I'm gluten intolerant.
God. You. What's your name?
Freddie Hamilton.
No, get up here, Freddie Mercury. All right. Now, do you have any money?
I have $10.
Awesome. Okay, you're gonna run out, get me a meatball sub with marinara sauce, extra cheese, and a large soda. A diet. I'm watching the fig.
Mr. Schneebly, we can't leave school.
Ever?
Not till the final bell.
Okay. All right. All right. Here's the deal. I've got a hangover. Now, who knows what that is?
It means you're drunk.
No. It means I was drunk yesterday.
It means you're an alcoholic.
Alcoholic. What's your name, exactly? Well, shut up, Jack Mooneyham! Listen, point is, today we're just gonna chill out, all right? We'll start on all the teaching crapola tomorrow, so just have fun, take recess, just please leave me alone. You, Little Miss Sunshine over there.
Summer half the way. Do you have any questions about our schedule? This sum usually starts with vocabulary, then followed by a word quiz, then she divides us into our reading groups.
Don't you understand that Mrs. Dumbbum or whoever's not your teacher anymore? I am, and I say recess.
My parents don't spend $50,000 a year for recess.
$50,000?
Mr. Schneebly, come with me. This poster here tracks our achievements. We get gold stars for how we do in class.
What kind of sick school is this? This is a tool of the man.
The who?
No, not the who, the man. Oh, you don't know the man? The man is everywhere. Miss Mullins, she's the man. The man is responsible for global warming and tuxedos and Jar Jar Binks and the Kardashians.
So what are we supposed to do about it?
Well, you've got to fight him with rock and roll and spirit and everything you've got to give.
That's all very well, but how are we supposed to get graded or get any gold stars if we just have recess?
Now, as long as I'm your teacher, there will be no gold stars, no grades, and absolutely no achievements. We're gonna have recess all the freaking time. Get it? Now recess, let's go, come on!
We'll see what Ms. Mullins has to say about this!
No, we won't. Now go, recess, get out!
Papers to grade, and, you know, I wouldn't want to betray 35 children.
Oh, that's my little nephew. Such a hard worker. Do you know how much I admire you?
Really?
Really.
Bye, my daddy bear.
Patty?
Everybody screaming, oh,
Hey, Joe.
Gabe. It's 10 o'clock. I stood in for your first period, but you...
What's that sound?
Your students. They have music studies now with Miss Mullins.
My kids? The spoiled brats with the gold stars are making that sound?
Yes.
My decisions.
But he tore.
It's time for class.
Wait.
Class.
I'm not alone. Oh, God. I'm not alone.
Does this mean no more recess?
I'll tell you what it means. It means we are going to compete in the Battle of the Bands!
What's the Battle of the Bands?
Excuse me? You have heard of earth and water, right? Air? Fire? Then how come you haven't heard about the Battle of the Bands?
This is some kind of dream of yours.
Yes, it's a dream of mine, little Miss Sunshine, but it's going to be a dream of yours, too.
I doubt it.
But you guys have a feeling for music. Real music, I heard you.
But classical music, Mr. Schneebly, not your kind of music.
Nonsense. Music speaks to you, and that is what matters. You, Zach, you ever play electric guitar?
My dad tells me it's a waste of time.
Oh, a waste of time? Okay. All right, well, it's a waste of time. A waste of time to put this on, right? Grab a hold of your axe and try to pluck out these rips. Okay. Let your shoulders relax. You don't want to be so stiff. Oh, awesome. Okay, good. Okay. Oh, yeah.
trumpet. You, what's your name? What was that big lumpy thing you were playing?
The cello.
The cello? Come here, I want to show you something. Put that on, okay? All right, let's rock. Okay, listen. You turn a cello this way, and it's practically like a bass. Pop the strings when you play, and watch how you shred my bass. Oh, she shreds my bass up. Okay, no, sorry, it's right there. All right. Keep on rapping each note, grab it right by the throat. Keep the rhythm afloat, but don't forget your ego, and that's all that she wrote. In the band. All right, you piano kid, come here. What was your name?
Lauren.
All right, whatever you, come here. All right. If you play the piano, you can play the keys.
Really play classical.
Okay. So just loosen it up and stretch your expertise.
I really don't think I can.
Okay, all right. Take a look at this music and let your mind expand. Going to be my drummer!
I play percussion!
You play the cymbal!
Shut up!
Okay. I'll sit your butt at the skids and try to whack out a beat. Okay, that's not bad. For my grandma who's dead. Okay, alright. I feel the groove in your kids and slowly turn up the heat. Oh, now you're playing like my grandma who's alive! Alright, there we go! Magic of rock.
We're not in the band?
Well, just because you're not in the band doesn't mean you're not in the band. I need backup singers. Who can sing? Anyone? You sing.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar.
Sing.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early?
Sing.
Marry all.
Okay, no. No. Backup singer, groupie.
What about the rest of us?
The rest of you. All right. Let's see. Okay, I'm ready. All right. I need a couple of roadies. I need someone on tech. Who wants to be security?
Can I be the stylist?
Check. They're awesome, they're like cheerleaders, only better.
No.
Okay. Oh, all right. Well, how about being manager?
Manager?
Is that something you could swear?
What does it mean?
It means I'm putting you in charge of the whole. We've got a band. All right, ready? You keep that thing coming, you don't change a thing. Alright, I want the chords in G, but real quick.
Someone get my bag. It's in the desk. Don't look at me when I'm like this. Jimi Hendrix by tomorrow, all right? Kate, come here. Les Claypool, listen to track 3, incredible, change your life.
Are we gonna be competing against other schools?
There's no question that a win will go in your permanent record. Hello, Harvard, hello, Yale, yo. But I can't put in a good word for you unless you clean this place up. I mean, Brody, Scott, all of you, what am I not paying you guys for? Let's go. Tamika, come here, come on, what's up? Come on, something's wrong. You can tell your old pal, Mr. Schneebly, what's going on?
You didn't give her a job.
Sure, okay, all right, do you want to sing? Do you want to be a backup singer with Marcy and the shit out? Okay, well, what do you want to do if you don't want to sing?
Mr. Schneebly, may I speak with you for a moment?
Okay, how about you think about what you want to do, and we'll talk about it later, all right? What upon me?
I don't think I should be in the band.
What? Why not?
People in bands are so cool. I'm just not cool enough to be in a band.
Dude, you're cool the way you play. Come on, why do you say you're not cool?
Nobody ever talks to me. I have no friends. Except Tamika. And she doesn't even speak.
Those days are over, all right? You trust me.
You wouldn't understand. You're too cool.
Hey, get back here. Come on, Papa Squad, next to Papa, let's have a little chat. You think I don't know what it's like to be fat and lonely, to have no friends, and to be left out of everything? Trust me, kid, I understand better than you know.
I never said I was fat.
Well, fat or thin, by the time I'm done with you, you'll be so cool, you'll be like a walking popsicle. Queen cool of all you survey.
Honest?
Honest.
Okay, I'm in.
My man.
Are we really gonna compete in the battle of the bands?
Is this guy kidding? With the talent you got, we'll do more than just compete. Yeah! We'll be so freaking hot, this is a band of bleed. Are you with me?
Yeah!
If you're willing to win, then it's time to begin. With the media spin, my OC kicks in, and it's time to go in.
Okay, Dad, I get the message.
Don't get the message. Should I tell you, do you even know why I'm paying for the school? Or why I'm paying for any Ivy League college? So you can have any career you choose.
I choose, or you choose.
Pick up that hammer and get some real work. What are you reading?
Sports Illustrated.
Vogue? I'm gonna go to my room.
No, you're not. You're gonna stay and watch the game.
Do I have to?
Yes, you're my son, goddammit, you're a Sanford. My dad played football, I played football. And you're gonna play football too, Billy. It's a legacy, you know. Sit down and watch the game.
But I don't fit in. I miss my old school.
Well, we love your new school.
Your old school is falling apart. Do you know how long we're on the waiting list for Horace Green?
I miss my friends.
Don't be silly. You can make friends anywhere you go.
BFF's besties.
They're so much smarter than me.
Tamika,
No one is smarter than you. No one is better than you. And how cute do you look in that uniform?
But I don't know how to talk to anyone.
Tamika, we know what's best for you.
Look, I'm not asking anymore. Just get it done, please.
Hey, Dad, you won't believe the
tape. What did I say when Daddy's on the phone?
You're working.
I'm working. Yeah, Jim? I want 10,000 shares in Northbrook Chemicals. Never mind why. I know what I know. Just get it done.
You always talk all the time.
Bob?
You never let me get in a word.
Will you be at the meeting tomorrow?
I wish I had a dime for every thought I swallowed unheard. No matter what it is that I do, it's like I just can't seem to get through.
I've got so much to say. If only you would listen. I've tried every which way, and still you never listen. Can't you see I'm hurting? I couldn't be more clear, but I promise one day I'll make you hear.
No, I tried to explain. I'm not the kid you want me to be, and yet it's all in vain. You just don't wanna see the real me. You think you know what I'm all about, and yet you just keep shutting me out. I've got so much to share. If only you would listen.
Appreciation and theory, and then band practice at the end of the day.
Wait, what about math?
Not important. Ozzy Osbourne doesn't do math.
Social studies?
Definitely not important. Mick Jagger does... No, look, guys, we gotta focus, all right? We gotta have a purpose here. Don't you want to win this contest? It's prestigious.
So, what are we gonna play?
You don't have to worry about that. We have awesome material, which I wrote.
Let's hear it.
Huh?
Let's hear your song.
Yeah. Come on. What, you wanna just hear my song? Okay, all right, I'll play you my song. Just know that I wrote it in like 15 minutes, so you know it's not done yet. It's not good even, you know, and you might not totally comprehend what's
just going play on. The song, Steve-ly.
Okay. Alright. I'll play it. I just gotta get in the zone first. I actually have a riff in here, so you know, once I'm going, I'm not gonna stop. Somebody better write this down. Okay. It begins on a dark stage. And then a beam of light, and you just see me and my guitar. Dear, near, in the end of time, there was a man who knew the road, and the writing was written on the stone. And then a thin layer of fog comes around my ankles. Roadies, this is called dry ice. We're gonna talk about this later. In the ancient time, an artist led the way, but no one seemed to understand. Chimes, Freddy. In his heart he knew that the artist must be true, but the legend of the ramps was way past due. And then Katie, you come in on the bass, Well, you think you'll be just fine without me, but you're mine. You think you can just kick me out of the band. And then Zach, you come in with the face melter. Well, there's just one problem there. The band is mine. How can you kick me out of what is mine? And then Freddy, you come in with the Hawaii 5-0 drum solo, just like, well, you're not hardcore unless you live hardcore. Oh, and the backup singers be like, cause you're not hardcore. Hardcore, unless you live hardcore, unless you live hardcore. But the legend of the rap was way hardcore. Bow, 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 confetti and explosions and panties all over the stage. And then that's all I got. I mean, right now it's just like a,
I liked it, Mr. Schneebly. I thought it was catchy.
Thank you, Summer Hathaway. Still not giving you a gold star. All right, everyone gather around. Time for lesson one of rock history. The 50s, rockabilly. No, not you, Billy. Pre-adults.
Making sure each child is drilled and ranked and filed by score.
Hello, all.
Hence one would expect our garishly bedecked new substitute to follow suit.
Sneely Go comes in and discipline goes out the door. Brownie, here at Forest Green, they're stolen glances. Psychedelic band as he's gone.
Let me the lock.
Parked in my slot.
With that naked lady picked and right on the rear.
Strokes me from past. All smelling bad.
Rather like patchouli.
Dirty sweat socks.
And fear.
his cocky, overconfident air.
Raised in his hair, he's a man.
Not awful lingo, but too crude to discuss.
Fluffy and the stupid coming back through his door, hard to ignore.
And furthermore, worst of all, the children all like him more than us.
Mr. Schneebly?
Actually, it's, Schneebly.
How are you finding the new school?
You know what they say, in marriage or teaching, the first month is always the hardest.
We were just discussing the testing. Which test do you prefer, the TASS or the Wilson-Bennett?
I say no testing.
No testing!
None at all. And I'll tell you why, Joe.
Gabe.
I believe that children are our future. Teach them well, but let them lead the way.
But that's a song.
I don't believe so.
Didn't Whitney Houston sing it?
I wish I knew what you were getting at.
I'm getting to the heart of it, Joe.
Gabe.
We are a team. We participate. And there is no I in participation. Oh, Rosalie, I've been looking all over for you.
It might be more appropriate to call me Miss Mullins.
It might be. It might be. It might not be.
It would be.
Anyway, I'm thinking about taking the kids away.
What?
A field trip. What do you say?
I say substitutes don't organize field trips.
Please, Miss Mullins, aren't I a little more than a substitute by now?
No.
But don't you think that kids can sometimes learn more outside of the classroom?
Mr. Schneebly, I can check, but there are safety issues. Parents have to be notified. It's not usual school policy.
Okay, you know what? Forget I said anything. We'll talk later. Joe, so you just tighten up the screws, all right?
Sure.
Katie? That was awesome. Zach, what's up with the stiffness, man? You're looking a little robotronic.
So I'll tell you what we're gonna do, all right? We're just gonna grease up the hinges, and loosey-goosey, baby, loosey-goosey.
I'm just playing it the way you told me.
And you know what? It's perfect. But that's the thing, all right? Rock is not about being perfect. Rock is not about the rules. Rock is not about getting A's, Summer. Who can tell me what rock is all about?
Scoring chicks.
Yeah, no.
Getting wasted.
No, guys, have you not been listening to me? Haven't you heard what I told you? Rock is about sticking it to the man.
Why can't it be a woman?
Yes, Summer, I grant you, the man can also be a woman.
Yeah, but you probably only get 70 cents a dollar.
Mm-hmm. Controversial. My point is that there are plenty of things in this world that are gonna piss you off. I don't care. Billy, what makes you really angry?
When my mom gets too much Botox, I can't tell if she's happy.
Okay, all right, not my point. My point is the man. All right, he's the one that makes the rules. He's the one that keeps you down. How does that make you feel?
I'm angry.
Damn right it should. The man is the one who's got to show what's up. All right, we're gonna send a little message to the man with our music. All right. When the world has screwed you and crushed you in its fist, when the way you're treated has got you good and pissed, there's been one solution since the world began. Don't just sit and take it, stick it to the man. Rant and rave and scream and shout, get all of your aggression up. They try to stop you, let them know exactly where they all can go. And do it just as loudly as a man. Stick it to the man. Right now, I'm your teacher, so I'm the man. So go ahead, stick it to me. Good start. Anyone else?
Sit down.
Whoa. Stop the wiggles, what we're gonna regret. Alright, so are we all feeling pissed off?
Yeah!
There's one thing that makes you more angry than anything else in the world, Katie.
Being over schedule!
Oh.
Yeah!
Parents overwork ya, stick you to the man. What else, you Freddy?
All the pressure!
All the pressure? All the pressure? Hate the way they jerk ya,
stick it to the man.
Yes, you're gaming. Zach, come here, what takes you off?
Well, my dad doesn't pay attention to me.
Mad when they ignore ya,
stick it to the man.
Here's the answer for ya,
stick it to the man.
Stand up to the system,
stick it to the man.
Rise up and resist them,
stick it to the man.
That's right.
Done.
Billy, what's up?
Phoenix Erectum!
Billy, we gotta have a talk, man, seriously.
Mr. Sheepley,
yeah?
I think we have it.
Hit me.
The School of Rock.
Whoa! The School of Rock? And we shall teach rock to the world! There's no way you can stop the School of Rock.
Yeah! When the world is shoot you and cuts you in its fists, when the way you cheat it has got you good and pissed, there's been one solution since the world began. Don't just sit and take it, sing it to the man.
Field trip for your class.
Yes, they have to qualify first, but that'll be figured out this afternoon.
Qualify?
For the field trip?
I was not aware that students had to qualify for a field trip.
This one is kind of unusual.
In what way?
Because of the unusual fields.
Well, anyway, I've checked and I was right. As I said, there is an insurance problem. You are only a substitute, and substitutes don't take field trips. And before you ask, there are no exceptions.
That's what? Right, we got hustles. Everyone ready?
Ready for what?
Ready to qualify, man.
How are we going to qualify if we can't leave the school?
What do you mean we can't leave the school?
Didn't Miss Wells just forbid it?
Dad, don't listen to her. All right, guys, gather around. I got a plan. Come on, listen out. When the bell rings for gym, which, by the way, totally pointless, we'll get the instruments into the van and go on my signal, all right, the whistle. We'll be back before anyone notices. But then
what? What happens if we qualify?
If we qualify? If? As a wise prophet once told me, we are the champions, my friends. Let's go, we don't have a lot of time, let's hustle. You know what to do.
Thank you.
much. I'll see you guys at the Battle of the Bands. Sign here.
Sorry about that.
We're late! We should have driven faster.
Oh, no, not with all of you in the van.
Careful, Mr. Schneebly. You're starting to sound responsible.
Remind me why you're here.
I'm the manager. We're booking our first show. Where else would I be?
Fair.
I thought we were competing against other schools.
Later. First, we go up against the big boys.
They're gonna make fun of us.
I don't understand. Why would they?
Because we don't know what we're doing?
Because we don't look like rock stars. We look like geeks.
Okay, all right, listen up. Listen up. Gather around. What you've got is what everyone wants, and that's talent. And as for looking like a rock star, did Mama Cass look like a rock star? No. She weighed, what, like 300 pounds? But when she was on stage, people worshipped her. She was a goddess.
What happened to her?
She choked to death on a ham sandwich. But that's not my point.
What is the point, Mr. Schneebly?
The point is that if we don't make the cut, we don't play in the battle. If we miss the battle, our whole project is shot. You'll all be failures, and you won't go to Harvard. But no pressure.
Well, you heard it. Let's get set up.
Go. I'm trying to find Jeff Sanderson.
Yeah, I am he.
Oh, they said you're in charge here?
I was in charge.
Well, what do you mean?
The auditions have finished. We only had a couple to see this morning. That one was the last, and now the bill's filled. Who are they?
Oh, my band!
Kids? Is this some sort of gimmick?
No, it's not a gimmick! Look, I know they're kids, but they're awesome. You just gotta listen.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I can't. I gotta go. Better luck next year.
There won't be a next year.
What?
There won't be a next year for any of us. Will there, Mr. Schneebly?
She's right, Jeff. I can't call you Jeff, right? You see, Jeff, I understand that you have to have your rules, but I mean, if it weren't for the fact that the Battle of the Bands has been keeping these kids alive, I know.
What do you mean?
Well, you see, Jeff, the kids have a condition.
What condition?
Rare blood disorder. Sticking to demandness.
Oh. Yeah, that. Wow. That's terrible.
Jeff, do you know the Yoda Hospice for Children Out of Luck?
No, I don't believe I do.
Well, it's a good place, Jeff, and the people there are good people, but they can't work miracles, Jeff. I only wish they could. Still, what the hell? You know, the dream of this contest has given them a few extra, nay, stolen weeks, which can't be bad, so thank you at least for that, Jeff. Thank you. All right, kids, let's go get all of your wheelchairs. Unless, of course, you know, you just listen, just so they haven't made the journey for nothing.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hey, kids! Let's
go!
Are you? 1, 2, 3!
We'll be right back.
everybody take your seats. Until Mr. Schneebly gets back to the faculty meeting, I am in charge.
Says who?
Says me, the band manager. Get it? Hey, ain't got all day. Get moving, only 36 hours until battle.
Presentations ready for tomorrow.
What's tomorrow?
The parents' meeting. Is there a problem, Mr. Schneebly?
No problem.
Good. The parents will need to see how their children are progressing. You'll need to prepare a few subject breakdowns and some work your pupils have completed in class.
Oh, I'd love to meet the parents. I'm so interested in their opinions of my work. Just one thing, how long is this gonna take?
They come when school finishes and they leave around 7. Bye.
Oh, no reason. I had something planned for later on, but I'm sure we'll be done in time.
Mr. Schneebly, parents' night is very important to me. They must leave with a smile on their faces.
And drugs are out of the question? Yes? No?
It's not a joke, Mr. Schneebly. They are my employers and they are your employers. We have to please them. Not going to keep you any longer. You have a busy afternoon ahead.
head.
Wow, she needs a good defrosting.
Yeah, well, she's not always the way she is at Horace Green.
I'll say. Remember at the teacher's convention when she was singing Dreams at the top of her lungs after just one beer?
What a lightweight.
Fleetwood Mac?
Ah, yes, she's a big Stevie Nicks fan.
Rosalie the Rock Chick is into Stevie Nicks?
Good to know.
Projects you've completed in class.
What written work?
What completed projects?
What are you going to do?
I don't know. What would you do, Summer? You're the one with the brains around here.
I don't know. You're the teacher.
If our parents are coming tomorrow, we won't be able to get away from the Battle of the Bands.
Oh, okay. All right. Don't worry. I'm working on it. Don't worry.
How? It's just not possible.
There's got to be a way.
Yes, there's got to be a way, and there will be. We just need to come up with a plan. So, anyone, ideas?
Mr. Stanley, what is
he? Hey! Oh, hold on. Tamika has something to say. Come on. This should be interesting. Front center, what's up?
Mr. Schneebly? I just wish.
Tamika, come on. I know you're shy, but I'm. Nope, not a mind reader.
I wish I was in the band.
Well, I wish you were in the band too, but do you play an instrument?
No. Well, you didn't want to sing. I do want to sing, but you asked me to be a backup singer, and I'm not a backup singer. I am a singer.
It's a little too late for that, Tamika. Okay, all right, how about this? If you sing something for me right now, maybe I can make you a singer. I can't make you a singer unless you can sing, though. All right, don't worry about it. No big deal, all right? No worries. All right, ideas. Let's go. Subjects.
We don't recognize that there are any boring subjects here at Horace Green.
Slightly boring?
You don't mind if I sit in on your classroom this afternoon, do you?
Oh, sure. Yeah, come on back this afternoon.
It is the afternoon, Mr. Schneebly. I meant now. Please continue with your...
is a wonderful thing. Math is a really cool thing. So get off your ass, let's do some math, 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 math. 42 divided by 6 is, Katie?
7.
And 55 divided by 5 is?
11.
Very good. And 74 is 65 more than, what is that number, 7?
9.
No, it's 8.
No, it's 9.
Yes, I know. I was just testing you. It's 9. And that's a magic number.
Oh, okay. All right, don't forget your homework. Tomorrow we begin on the rhythm of logarithms. But first we sing the key points in the life of President. Great. Now go, go, go. You know what to do.
Your methods are certainly very unusual, Mr. Schneebly.
That's funny. They don't seem unusual to me. But then I did study under Errol von Strassen, Bergen, Baker, Bergen, and he made Rudolf Steiner look like Mary Poppins.
Did he? Well, let me be very clear, Mr. Schneebly. We are not interested in experimental philosophy here at Horace Green. Music is for music class. And math is for math class. Got it?
Got it.
Good.
Do you want to grab a drink?
What?
Like a coffee?
You're asking me to go for a coffee with you.
Ooh, I guess I am. Come on, bell rang, school's out for the day. What do you say?
I have things to do.
Oh, what kind of things?
Principal kind of things.
Okay, how about after that, you meet me at the Roadhouse.
The Roadhouse? The dive bar?
Yes, you know it then.
Yes.
The Roadhouse then.
The Roadhouse.
At 7.
At 7.
Great, it's a date. Dismissed.
Are you sure they don't have any coffee?
Mm-hmm.
No coffee?
Strange, isn't it?
And there's nowhere else, not even a Starbucks?
Hey, can I get a pitcher?
Mr. Schneebly.
I'm having another, and you wouldn't want me to drink alone, would you?
I don't think either of us should be drinking at all. Mr. Schneebly, I've been...
You should call me Dewey.
Why would I call you Dewey?
Ned! Dewey's my other name. My middle name, Ned. Dewey Schneebly.
Some people are born lucky. So is there a Mrs. Ned Dewey?
No, I'm not really in the financial position to date right now. And besides, most girls end up wanting me to be something that I'm not. You know, like, handsome. You know what? I'm going to go put on a random song.
You know, this is the first time a teacher's ever asked me to do anything outside of school.
Really?
It's true, not in 6 years.
Oh, I bet they're just intimidated.
It's not that. They hate me.
Oh, come on. They do not.
Oh, yes, they do. Ooh. You know, I was fun once. Funny even. But you can't be funny in the principal.
because when it comes to their kids, parents have no sense of humor.
You think that's when it matters the most?
Nothing else matters. And I've got to be perfect. And I'm not kidding. That pressure's turned me into... Oh, you know what it's turned me into.
No, I don't. What?
Bitch. Bitch.
What? I love this song.
Wait, you love Stevie Nicks?
I love Stevie Nicks.
Oh, this is my favorite part. What?
When I first laid all in,
you shut up. I'm a
little bit 17.
It's like a religion for me, I swear.
Love sings and songs and action singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, S.A. ooh.
Have you seen her live?
Yes, she played here in town once. I will never forget it.
It's such a coincidence. We're like one person, Rosalie Mullins. I love Stevie Nicks. You love Stevie Nicks.
Yeah.
I love freedom. You love freedom.
I do love freedom.
I knew it. I knew it from the first time I saw you.
You did?
Yeah. I could tell deep inside you are just like me. There's music inside you most definitely, and you keep it locked up when it really should be in flight. Just like tonight. Well, am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
Back when I was younger, wild and bold and free, I can still remember how the music used to be. Chords like rolling thunder, loud beyond control. Every note and lyric branded right across my soul. It's fun.
first. Please, I'll be okay. Let's keep this our secret. Could believe anyway. We'll pretend it never happened. File it and forget. It's dead. Thanks for the reminder. Drop his music in the air. I have to go.
Wait, Rosalie. You're sure about this field trip?
What is it?
A concert. Tomorrow night, it would be like you seeing Stevie for the first time. I think it would be so awesome for these kids.
It would be awesome, but would it be educational?
It would be an education that they would never forget.
Okay, help me send those parents home happy tomorrow night, and I will see if the school can make an exception. Deal? You didn't have to do that. You already had permission.
I know. I wanted to. Good night, Rosalie Mullins.
Good night, Mr. Schneebly.
Huge plans. Also, don't wait up late for me, because I'm going to be home very late tonight.
Oh, I won't. I'm taking Patty to Applebee's.
Ned! You got a letter in the mail from Horace Green.
Really?
You never told me you sent in your resume.
They never answered.
Oh, well, they've answered now. Oh, you deserve this, Ned. You deserve the best.
Whoa! Hello, why would Horace Green send me a check for $2,600?
What? Why? You never worked there.
Oh, sure he did. He just must have forgot.
I think I'd remember if I'd worked at Horace Green.
They've obviously mixed up the checks. But they must want you for an interview. Call them. I have to go to work, but I'm so proud of you, Ned. Call them. Now.
Oh, you mean now. Have you seen my cell phone?
Oh, yeah, it's actually in your room. Oh, over that way.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
You've got my letter.
Oh, yeah.
Give it back, I need to call them.
Why, can't you spend the money?
It's not mine, Dewey, I didn't earn it.
So it's like a bonus. Come on, spend it.
And wind up in court for misappropriating funds? Dewey Finn, financial advisor. I don't think so.
I said to make it up to cash! Ned, sit. Ned, please sit. Don't go away. Breathe with me. All right, breathe in. Would you believe me if I told you that I've done very bad things?
Oh, so easily. So very easily.
Okay, well, you know I'm not the type of guy to take advantage of his friends.
Only because you haven't got me friends.
I promise you'd have done the same if you were me.
How? If I were you, I'd have jumped off a tall building long ago.
Ouch. Ned, if I tell you something, will you promise not to tell Patty?
Sure.
No, don't say sure like that, okay? It's not sure. It's not even likely. She is stronger than either of us. She is stronger than Washington. She is stronger than the sea.
I said I won't tell her, so I won't tell her.
Enough refreshments.
Tea, coffee, and we have some wine.
Hold the wine to the end. Too early, that fuels their anger.
Crosley! I had a great time last
night. Miss Mullins, Mr. Schneebly. I should be Miss Mullins here at Horace Green, and you should be Mr. Schneebly here at Horace Green. But thank you again for last night.
And I'm still taking the kids to the concert tonight.
Yes, if the parents go home happy, the school will make an exception. I cannot stress how important tonight is.
Got it. Yeah.
He'll be here anyway.
Hey, you're gonna be awesome. I've ordered the school bus for tonight.
And we really have permission?
Yes, I told you we have permission to go to our concert. Excuse me.
What do you think?
What, did I lose a competition? It looks like Siegfried and Wrong.
It's glitter rock. It's glam. It's fabulous. Have you no vision?
I have 20/20 vision, all right? I have seen salads dressed better than this. This is not style.
You talk to me about style. You can't even dress yourself. You wear the same ugly clothes every day. Fine, I give up. I guess they can just wear their uniforms.
That's not a bad idea.
Not a bad idea. I was kidding.
Hey, what is that? No, no, don't stop.
It's nothing. It was just an idea I was fooling around with.
You wrote it? You wrote a song? Play it. I want to hear it.
I'm not much of a singer.
Play it.
Stuck in the dark days. Don't take much to memorize your lines. I feel like I've been hypnotized.
It's great, Zach.
You really like it?
I really like it because it's really good. Lauren, Freddie, Katie, rock positions. Let's go.
Wait, what are you doing?
We're gonna learn your song, man.
Why?
Because that's what bands do. You have lyrics? Yeah? Okay, all right, what are the chords? Rock got no reason. Rock got no rhyme.
Huh?
Yeah? Cool? Awesome. Freddie? He's there. He's always there. Katie, come on, give me the face. Backup girls, we're gonna need some ooh-la-la. So just give me like,
ooh-la-la-la, ooh-la-la-la. Make up some funky dance moves, you know.
All right. Freddie, take it from the chorus. Count me in.
1, 2, 3.
And if you want me,
explain everything. No worries at all. Get comfortable. There will be refreshments later. Just have a seat, please. Okay, all right. Hello, I am Ned Schneebly, Mrs. Dunham's substitute, and over the past few weeks, I've gotten to know your kids. Your kids. Zach, you say that he isn't smart? Are you crazy? He's an incredible guitarist, and mine. You should hear the kid play. I mean, he's the next Hendrix. And Freddie and Katie, they can jam with the best of them. But more importantly, since they've picked up these instruments, they've grown so much. I've seen it. They're great, great kids. You say Lauren plays keyboards all day, right? Well, why shouldn't she? She's insane. She is going to go down in the rock record book. She is a rock goddess. I mean, just look at her. Marcy and Chanel, they've got the voices of angels. I worship every note that comes out of their mouths. And Tamika's a star. And don't even get me started on Summer. Summer is going to be the first woman president of the United States. She could run in 2020, and I'd vote for her. My point is, they're all really cool kids. If they were mine, I'd be so proud. I am proud.
He's an imposter!
Ned, you told Patty?
She got it out of me, sorry.
Don't apologize.
Sorry.
What the hell is going on?
I'll tell you what's going on. This is the real Ned Schneebly. And this loser is doing me. He's not even a real teacher. He can barely read.
Okay, let me speak. All right. All right, yes, I confess that my actual name is Dewey Bin.
No!
Yes, indeed. And although you should know I'm not licensed to teach, I promise you I can read.
Oh my God!
But forgetful what I might happen to be, these children of yours have truly touched me, and I can assure you I have definitely touched them. Well, most of them.
I'm not sure that the poor got a super easy.
No way!
Tell us how.
Together and take charge. You can do it. You're a strong woman and a good principal. And I don't want to hear any more self-doubt today. Now, I'll see what I can do about the parents.
No hurry.
Mason, where are the other children?
I can't say. They're waiting. I forgot my computer and I'm running the lights from it.
You're not going anywhere, Mason. What lighting? What computer? Keeping who waiting?
We got the instruments. Well, we have to pick up Mr. Schneebly, and then we'll compete in the battle of the bands.
You know, he's not really Mr. Schneebly. He's Mr. Finn.
What's the difference? We're a good band, Miss Mullins.
Yeah.
We've worked so hard for this show.
But he's not who he says he is.
Who cares? He taught us that rock can set us free. We can't fail him now.
Ms. Mullins, the parents are back, and they're demanding a meeting right now.
Go, I'll handle this.
You're the best, Ms. Mullins!
What are you doing here?
I don't have any other place to go.
Oh yeah, we'll find a place.
All I was trying to...
I don't want to hear anything you have to say. You know, I've never liked you, and now you bring this mess on our doorstep. Do you realize how serious this is, Dewey? We're talking about children. Young, vulnerable children.
But they were all so...
Don't you understand, you idiot? This is fraud. You could go to prison. What were you thinking?
I was just trying to pay the rent.
Oh, don't you dare blame us. Oh, you're delusional. You're sick. I don't even want to be around
you. Penny, that's enough!
I'm going. And when I get back, I want him out of here.
She's right, you know. She's a pain.
She may be a pain,
but she's right. You've done some really messed up stuff, but this is unforgivable. Did you even think about me?
You're not involved.
Oh, no? I could lose my teaching license. My license, the apartment, this could screw up my entire life.
Ned, I'm so sorry.
It's too late for that. I want you out. Me. Go, it's over. I love playing music with you. It was the best time of my life, but... maybe some people just aren't born to be rock stars. Did you ever think about that?
Shoot.
Whoa, guys, what are you doing here?
We're from the venue, the bus is outside.
We have to go. Guys, listen, all right? I'm a loser. Just please go back to school.
Oh, yeah, didn't you hear us? The bus is outside. We have to go!
Just please go back to your lives, right? Just please leave
me alone.
Mr.
Schneebly, you can't give up now!
Mr. Schneebly, I lied to you, all right? I lied to you, and I used you, and worst of all, I wasted your time. Just please don't just change my back to your body. No, you have to go.
I was lost and in.
Thank you. our next act is a favorite band of mine, No Vacancy!
Baby, we were made in
told you you'd make new friends. But you need to be careful of straining your throat, honey, because them vocals was dope.
Zach, come over here.
Are you mad at me?
Mad? I love you, son. I've never been more proud.
Dewey! Ned! Dewey, that was amazing!
You look incredible!
Dewey, you did it.
No, it was all of them, man. These kids did it.
Say it with me.
Megadeth Mania! Megadeth Mania! Megadeth Mania!
Well, hold on, I have to take care of something. Yeah, Megadeth Mania. Hi! I'm sorry, they came to my house.
There he is! That's the man. Take him.
Is there a problem, officer?
No.
There must be a problem.
There's been a report of this teacher.
Teacher? He's not a teacher at all.
No, he's not a teacher. Mr. Finn is our... He's our music coach, and he's perfectly qualified to do that.
There seems to have been a mistake.
Now, wait a minute.
Patty, give it up. It's over.
Ned!
Forget Applebee's, I'm taking you to Red Lobster!
You didn't really mean that, right? What you said about the whole music coach thing?
I don't know, let's try it. Don't you have to class? I'll tell you one
thing, Dewey Finn. I have never felt so cool in my entire life.
And the winner of this year's Battle of the Bands is...
Thank you.
And are you having a good time?
No!
All right, then let's close this baby out. I got a few special people I want you to meet. They're all dear, dear friends of mine. First, give it up for the heartthrobbers I know. Nerd, Bono! Our fabulous pimp band, and all the stage managers and all the stage managers and technicians in the booth and behind the scenes that make this whole thing possible. Thank you guys, have a great night. Drive safe.
It's the one.
Hamilton on drums.